This slide here is to show a little bit, how do I evaluate, does this saddle fit? First look, this is a dressage saddle. The cantle should always be slightly higher than the pommel. We wanted to see if the saddle is clearly behind the shoulder blade for maximum rotation for the shoulders and freedom of the shoulders. You can go to the horse and you can see where the hairline comes together. You can also feel the last rib. And where the hairline goes together and you go straight up, you will see the last rib and the hairline will meet one point. So you like to see your saddle sitting behind the shoulder and in front of the lumbar. This is the actual saddle support area where I focus on. So I got my balance, I'm off the shoulder, and I'm off the lumbar area on this particular horse. The next thing is the girth. The sternum is approximately 6 inches long, some horses up to 8. And the saddle should, the girth should never pass this point because we got solar plexus here. And when we push against that spot, the horse will actually move away from it, so it's a very sensitive area. So the girth should sit a hand width behind this area. The billets of your saddle, if it's a short billet system, you sometimes have 4 short billets, or some of them have long billets. Now the billets should be always perpendicular and match straight up where the girth area is. Here you can see in this particular case, these billets hang too far back of the girth area. If I say, okay, here's the girth area, and I pull the billets forward, this will drive the saddle into the shoulder, make the saddle go up too high of the horse, and the rider will lean back, and the leg will come forward into a chair seat. Biggest problem we will see when that's the case is that we will have a lot of saddles which could actually put damage to the cartilage and chop off part of the cartilage of the shoulder. The solution is to have a saddle what allows these billets to come out in front so they align up with the girth area. So they align up with the girth area and they hang perpendicular to the ground. Here we can see clearly the saddle is being too far back. The gullet plate is where these nails are on your saddle. And you would like to have the saddle sitting against the edge of the shoulder. If you put the saddle that far back, you see where we have the last rib is right here, and right here is where the lumbars are. Very, very sensitive area. So if we move the saddle more forward against the shoulder blade, the saddle would not put pressure onto the lumbar area, and the saddle would not cause the horse to buck or to trip or to fall. What the horse will do, whatever he or she can do in order to move the saddle away of the lower back. Look how far back the billets are now, if they would come out of the front. Even if you are moving the billets far forward, you can see nicely the sternum here. The billets in the most forward position would hit the solar plexus of the horse, and the horse would jump away from it. The girth will be pulling the saddle into the forward movement, and now all the hairline is moved forward, and all the hair follicles will get irritated, and then we start having all of a sudden a complete different saddle fitting problem, which is skin irritation and loose girth and moving saddle, and one thing leads to another.